I convinced a doctor I needed Xanax, and I remember my ex, who I lived with at the time, said that I was sleepwalking and saying some crazy things while on Xanax and alcohol. I took a baseball bat to his windshield one night for no reason. The cops came out. Luckily, I didn't get arrested. I don't remember any of it. Just woke up the next day. I had, you know, bruises on my hands, and my ex was pissed. He showed me his truck, and I had no idea what I did, and that was the mixture of Xanax with alcohol. So I can't remember which I ever did first, OxyContin or cocaine, but I was always drinking. I always had alcohol in my system. I didn't like marijuana. I know I did that before any other drugs, but I never liked the high I got off of marijuana. It made me feel kind of out of my own mind and very paranoid. I loved alcohol because it calmed me down. It made me feel confident. It made me feel like I could do anything in the world. It made me feel like I was funny. I genuinely thought I was a funnier human being when I was drunk. I genuinely thought I was a lot smarter when I was drunk. When I was sober, I would stutter or I would get nervous and I'd forget words. And so I was like, I have to be drunk because it makes me so smart. Because I would drink so much, I would get tired or not be able to really finish my bartending shift because I'm like stumbling over the bar mats. I found out cocaine is very easily accessible when you work in the service industry. And I don't remember the first time I ever tried it, but I just remember just feeling awake, like just feeling alive. It was like the best high. I was so happy. I was running around. I could do anything. I started doing cocaine a lot, even when I wouldn't drink. I would wake up in the morning and do cocaine. So that was the only one I think I ever did without alcohol because I really liked the high of it. It just made me feel like I was on top of the world. I would clean the whole house. You know, I would call my parents and talk to them for, you know, 45 minutes. Of course, I didn't realize that they knew I was high on cocaine because apparently your entire vocal cords change and, you know, you don't stop talking. I don't think I had any punctuation or anything. But I was very happy. I was so nice to everybody. I loved people for about 30, 40 minutes, and then I would want more. And then I would get really testy. I would get really just moody and didn't really have patience for anyone, very irritable, until I could get more cocaine. And I hated the downs of cocaine so much because I wouldn't be able to sleep. You know, I took it, which is ironic because I took it so I would stay awake while I drank, but then I wouldn't be able to sleep either because, you know, even hours later because it's still in my system and I was feeling like crap and I wasn't feeling that high anymore. I was just feeling just exhausted, but I couldn't sleep. My mind was like going a, you know, mile a minute. So I hated that part of cocaine. So when I could, I would also buy OxyContins from the same people and at work. Usually the dishwashers in the kitchen are always selling stuff. So those were very expensive. It was about 30 bucks a pill. And I remember the first time I took a whole one and I threw up everywhere. I was so sick from it. So I wasn't like, oh, it's the Oxy. Maybe I just don't like the Oxys. No, I just was like, no, I just did it wrong. So I took half a pill the next time. And it always increased my alcohol. The feelings I would get from alcohol, it made them, you know, 10 times more intense. That kind of euphoric feeling and almost like floating, I would get that. And I loved getting the, you know, itchy, where you feel, you know, like you have to scratch. A big problem with the pills for me was you have to eat something on them or else I would throw up. So I had to have something in my stomach, didn't like to eat, especially if I had just done cocaine. Even when the cocaine was, basically the high was out of my system, I would not feel hungry. I would still be, you know, just very, just not wanting anything else, consuming anything else. Taking an Oxy at that point was awful because I had to eat something. I didn't want to, but I knew I would get sick, so I would have to do that. I slept very deep with Oxys. I had always blacked out with Oxys. I knew that I slept a lot deeper. I knew that I was definitely in a more depressed state physically when I took the Oxys. I didn't really care if I died in my sleep or anything because I loved the high. I loved being on pills. And the high from the cocaine I really loved because I was so friendly and talkative and I was just the best bartender you could ever want, but it would only last for about 40 minutes until I needed another hit. And that got a little scary dealing with because I had a coke dealer that was after me for money because I never had enough money to pay for my drugs up front. Definitely a lot of issues with drugs and mixing the alcohol and drugs. I always liked it initially, never liked it after a little while. The oxys would make me feel just sick and too lethargic to do anything. The cocaine would keep me up. It would make me, you know, kind of paranoid. It would actually make me angry, I think. You know, the first few highs were always great, but then it was just miserable. So that's kind of why I went back to alcohol, because no matter what, alcohol was my friend. I knew I was gonna numb out and pass out and black out, and that was fine with me. I was ready to just erase my entire life.